Hi, my name's Kent. I'm a creative specialist at Google, and I'd like to show how to create dynamic videos in Google Web Designer. These are video ads often produced in batches with variations. So for example, you might have 100 videos of the same ad, but each one includes some custom content, like a city name, price, or imagery to reflect the time of day or weather. Then those videos can be published on YouTube, Facebook, or another platform which serves the version most relevant for each viewer. Unlike dynamic HTML5 ads, we're not creating these video variants dynamically with a data feed as the ad is served. But instead, we're creating separate videos in advance, and then with targeting in the campaign setup, the most relevant one is shown. Here's an example, a video ad I've built from scratch in Google Web Designer. I'll just play it first. It's pretty simple. I have 3 video clips, a logo, some text, and an audio track. Now suppose there are 10 dealers in my area, so I just want to change the store name at the end. And I'll be showing these to people based on their location. Here's an example of a finished variant. The main change is the store name, but I also used a different ending video clip and a different logo moved to the other side and constrained the text to a smaller area. For every element I want to be dynamic, I'll first add a binding, which describes what I want to change about it, then use the Variants tab to set the content for each variant. So to start, I'll navigate to the text, right-click, Add Variant Binding, to the HTML content, which I use instead of text content because in this case I want to capture the bold formatted store name. And while I'm here, I'll just point out you can also change all the text styles like the font, style, weight, color, and position. Then switch to the Variants tab. Click the first icon to create a new variant, right-click to rename it, and the pencil icon to set the new content. Notice I've written the bold tags right into this line. And we see it updated on the stage. Click the X or arrow to go back to the variants list view. Notice the variants panel has 2 states, the list view and the variant editor. Now onto the other dynamic items, starting with the closing video clip. I'll go to the root div, then scrub to the clip I want to change, right-click it in the timeline, add a binding to the source, notice the endpoint is also an option, then back in my variants panel, open Hibiscus and set its source clip. Since we're on clips, I want to point out the distinction between clips and the video track containing them. Video tracks have all different bindings, colors, size, position, opacity, and these will affect every clip in the track. And this one, Show Element, is worth a look. And we also saw this as a text binding. Notice the video disappeared. Not just this clip, but all clips in the track. By default, Show Element is hidden in all variants. And if I wanted to show it, now there's a checkbox in the variant controls to do so. So Show Element is used basically to hide stuff. I'll just delete it since I don't really need it in this file. I'll scrub through, and now I see my text is overlapping the bottle in this new clip. So here's how to fix that. I've already set up this text to stay right aligned and enabled text fitting so longer store names will shrink to fit. So really all I need to do here is change the width of the container element. I'll right click to add a variant binding to the width, then open the variant and set a smaller value. And automatically, my text becomes small enough to stay off the bottle in this video. Last is the logo, and by now it should be pretty routine. I'll just right-click it to add a binding to the source, then open the variant and change it. And if I wanted to, I could move it over to the other side. Add another binding to the left, and change that. So that finishes this file, but I just want to quickly mention dynamic audio. Audio clips can also be bound to the endpoint and source, just like video. But they also include volume, which is handy when you have multiple clips you want to normalize. Audio tracks can bind to mute, silencing every clip in the track. And now the last thing I want to show is more of an advanced feature for importing and exporting CSV files. These are spreadsheets for creating lots of video variants. From this file, I can export a CSV of the variants, although I only have one for now. In the Variants panel, click the middle Export button and Save. Then open the project folder and you'll find a file ending with CSV, which stands for comma-separated values. And if I open the file, here's what I see. All my variants and all my data, even though it's a little hard to read. Now, if I wanted to create 100 variants of this video, the quickest way is to make all the edits in this file. Then I can import it and the rest is automatic. So here's how to do that. Open Google Sheets and start a new blank spreadsheet. Then File, Import, Upload, and drag that CSV into here. I'll leave the default settings and import data. Now it's a little easier to read. I see the names of my dynamic elements in the top row and the variant values in the other rows. And I create new variants in this spreadsheet with just text. So that's one, and I can continue, but I'll skip ahead to a version I've already filled out with 100 variants. Any field left blank would just use the default content. When you're done editing, choose File, Download, CSV, and save it. Then back in GWD, in the Variants panel, click the third button icon, Import Variants, and select that new CSV in the Downloads folder. But be careful because this will overwrite any variants you've already entered manually in the Variants panel. And instantly, I've created 100 different versions of this video. I'll play one to verify. That looks good. I can see the logo is different. The last step is to export all these video variants. Publish locally, and for variants, select all. Video output has some options, and to save time, I'm just going to choose half size for resolution. Leave this set to my preview time range, and export. Now this part will take a while because I have so many videos. So I'm going to fast forward about 5 minutes, but that's still pretty fast because it's less than the total playing time of all these videos. My exports are done, so I'll close the render dialog and open my project folder. And here's all 100 variants. I'll play the last one, which I know should end with the Peach video. And there's the Peach ending as expected. So that's how you create hundreds of video variants quickly with Google Web Designer. That's it for Dynamic Video. Thanks for watching.